Yo, what up, man? Hey, it's your boy, comedian Jay Scott, man. I know you see me right now, and you're like, God damn, nigga, your head looks huge. Yeah, my head is big, man. So, it is what it is. Your boy, I'm in the building, man. I decided to go live on the Facebook. You know what I mean? So, hold on. You know what I mean? The last show I had, man, I pretty much had a working with a whole new software. Working with a whole new thing. So, you know what I mean? I have to get adjusted to that type of shit. So, yeah, you know what I mean? I figured I'd go ahead and go live on this Facebook, man, and probably upload it to YouTube. You feel me? So, you know what I'm saying? Appreciate those that, you know what I mean, are getting ready to check me out, man. You know what I mean? Those that are in the building with me. You feel me? Hold on, let me see, man. I'm gonna need to go sit down. I'm gonna go sit down right quick. But yeah, you know, I appreciate those that's in the building with me, man. I'm just gonna be kind of, you know, brief, man. I'm not really gonna go in too much, man, because I don't want Facebook to shut me down. you know what I'm saying? But let me see how long they're gonna let me on here. You know what I mean? And I can't see how much time I'm working with on here, man. So, you know, bear with me. You know, I don't know how much time it is, so I'm going to see if I can time it up right on here. But, yeah, you know what I'm saying? I'm in the building, man. You know, I hope everybody had a good weekend. You know what I mean? Appreciate those that's in the chat room right now. I see you, Marcus Cuzzo, my cousin Marcus, you know what I'm saying? He's in Chicago. Follow that brother, you know what I'm saying? Marcus Jordan, you know what I'm saying? Real talk, true story. My nigga Quasimodo, a.k.a. Freak Nasty, is in the building, you know what I'm saying? My nigga HT, you know, he's in the building. Yeah, so, you know, I'm in this thing right now, man. You know, I hope everybody's having a pretty good weekend, man. I just want to, you know, talk a little bit. I know people watching the football games and shit, man. You know, my team, the Colts, they seem to be losing right now. I can't really tell because I'm in Texas. And in here in Texas, they show nothing but Texas shit. So, nothing but Texas football games, you know what I mean? That's all they do. So, I'm going to try to get some little space, man, because I know if I keep going too close, man, my head's just going to get bigger and bigger, you understand? So, I'm going to try to keep some type of distance. Like I said, Sunday, you know, it's 9/11, you know what I mean? September 11th. You know, this is, for some reason, America likes to celebrate deaths and destruction. Nigga HT say he taking a knee right now. Hey, I feel you, man. I feel you, man. I feel you. Hey, I woke up this morning, man, heard all types of national anthems going off. You understand what I'm saying? Then it's all, you know what I'm saying, this 9/11 thing is wicked. You know what I'm saying? Only because, you know, there's so many questions around what happened, you know, and I remember, you know, everybody remembers where they were at when 9/11 popped off, you know what I mean? I remember where I was at, you know what I mean? I was in college, you know what I mean? And I remember when it happened, I was ready to go to class, and all of a sudden, boom, it hit the first building, and I was like, oh, shit, son, I ain't going to class, nigga. This is history I'm watching right here. So I sat there, watched the whole shit, you know what I'm saying? And then not until afterwards did it really even come to light, you know what I'm saying? You know, how it all, you know, kind of played out. And then the conspiracies came in and all that other shit, you know. Quasimodo, you silly, man. Right on for the, yeah, you know, you already know, man. Freak Nasty. Looking ass nigga. But you know what I'm saying, the 9/11 thing jumped off, and you know, they all type of conspiracies came out, you know what I mean? Some doctors and not doctors, but some scientists and all types of people were trying to figure out, you know what I mean, if planes can really make buildings blow up, you know, that's the whole shindig, you know, that's the whole thing about it, is can planes make buildings blow up? Can the 747 hit the Pentagon and just put a little hole in it? Nigga, is that glitter on my face, nigga? The fuck? That's the question. And, you know, a lot of people didn't show up to work that day, which they don't report. But you know what I'm saying? Shit happens, man. You know what I mean? Gave George W. The right to basically go ham out here on the war tip. You know what I mean? So some real shit popped off 9/11. So bring it all back today. These football games on Sunday, first week. It's like, you know what I'm saying? I'm trying to remember. Have they always done Sunday games when the first week? Or don't they usually have Monday night game first and then the first week after that? Like, the Monday night game and then it'd be the Sunday game later on that week. I don't remember the Sunday game. Now, I know they added some more games to the schedule, so that could possibly be it. But I know today, man, they were letting freedom ring with these damn national anthems, man. I guarantee you're going to be seeing some more national anthems. You know what I'm saying? Definitely popping off tomorrow for the Monday night game. You know what I'm saying? They're going to make sure, I think San Francisco's playing tomorrow. So we're going to see what they do to Colin Kaepernick and see if they ridicule him and keep doing those things. You know what I'm saying? You know, Colin Kaepernick, you know what I'm saying? He's cool with me, man. He should be cool with a lot of black people, man. A lot of people, period. You know what I'm saying? Now, they trying to compare him to, like, when James Brown and Muhammad Ali, when they all got together, they trying to compare him to that movement. I don't really see that movement, you know what I'm saying? Because that meeting that Muhammad Ali and, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar was there, Jim Brown was there. That meeting they had at that time period, that was some real revolutionary type shit, you know what I mean? Now, athletes trying to stand up for, you know what I mean, they people, that was, like, unheard of, you know what I'm saying? And the first. So it's like Kaepernick doing that shit is cool, but now a lot of sports people are taking these. Oh shit, somebody just got fucked up. But I mean, a lot of people are taking knees at these games and shit. They even doing it in high school now. They doing high school people not standing for the anthem, you know what I'm saying? High school athletes is kneeling down and shit. What up, Sylvester Reeves? This nigga put his government name on the shit, aka Snoop. What up, nigga? But yeah, man, you know what I'm saying? A lot of these athletes are kind of sticking up and trying to, you know, make that silent movement, you know what I'm saying? That silent signature or that silent symbol of, you know what I mean, a movement, you know what I mean? So it's crazy out here right now, you know what I mean? It's definitely crazy out here. You know, the national anthem, Colin Kaepernick, Donald Trump, you know what I'm saying? I'm not going to really say too much about Donald Trump because last time I said something about Donald Trump, man, they cut my Facebook off, you know what I mean? So I'm not really even going to say nothing about Donald Trump, you understand what I'm saying? Do what you do, my nigga. I hope Donald Trump, I ain't gonna lie, I hope Donald Trump wins. How about that? People can fuck off, nigga. I don't give a fuck. I hope Donald Trump wins, nigga. I'm not voting. I'm not voting for none of them shits. Okay? I don't know if y'all voting for any of them people. I'm not voting. I'm not voting for Hillary. I'm not voting for Donald Trump. I think they got some independent person in the mix. I ain't voting for him. I ain't voting for nobody. I ain't voting for shit until we get some type of economic status, economic base, financial shit popping with black people. That's when I'll go vote. The moment we can take our money and go to politicians and let these politicians know that we ain't bullshitting out here and we need some type of for real differences made in our communities, and we can, you know, come up with an agenda, write it out, get it all written up, whipped up, and sent to the people, you know what I'm saying, sent to Congress, sent to these politicians, until we can get to that status, nigga, I ain't voting for shit, nigga, I ain't voting for a goddamn thing, nigga, fuck voting, yeah, you heard me say it, nigga, fuck voting. The only reason why we vote, and you know, I'm going to quote my brother Tariq Nasheed, the only reason why black people vote is for history, and because that's what our parents did, and our great-great parents, and the right to vote and all that. But we still ain't changed shit. We have no constitutional rights at all right now, y'all. So what's the point of voting, man? What's the point of voting? Ain't no point of voting. You understand what I'm saying? Ain't no point of voting right now. You know what I mean? We need an economic base to get this shit popping. So I'm not voting for shit. I'm going to tell you right now. I remember Bernie Sanders was running, nigga. Motherfucking Colonel Sanders can run, nigga. Colonel Sanders from Kentucky Fried Chicken can run for president right now. And I'm voting for KFC, nigga. Who ain't gonna vote for Kentucky Fried Chicken, huh? Who ain't gonna vote if you get motherfucking bucket of chicken, 20 pieces of chicken on Tuesdays, the 20-piece Tuesday? Who gonna turn that shit down, nigga? It be people voting right now for the Colonel. You understand what I'm saying? Colonel Sanders can run right now, and he would probably win the motherfucking presidency. You understand what I'm saying? I can't fuck with it, people. I'm sorry, man. I can't do it, man. You know what I mean? You know, shout out to those that's fucking with me live right now. You know what I'm saying? That's watching me live. You understand what I'm saying? I appreciate the love. I went ahead and switched up and tried to go live on Facebook. Just because the other, like I said, the other software that I've been dealing with, you know what I'm saying? I'm trying to maneuver. You understand what I'm saying? So sometimes you got to adjust. So I appreciate those that's riding with me right now. And I mean, speaking of the presidency, I'm looking at the news, man. I'm looking at some of these news articles, and they talking about Hillary Clinton may have health issues. Now, I'm gonna be honest with you. I heard about this maybe a couple weeks ago, but I didn't know if it was true. But fucking Hillary Clinton may have health issues. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to read this report. And actually, let me see if I can maybe look it up. See if y'all can see this shit. Now, what you just saw right there, that was Hillary Clinton, Hillary Clinton, she was attending a 9/11 ceremony, and during the ceremony, they said that she got overheated, and I think she had to leave. Now, you know, what's interesting, man, is that you know, they said that it was from her overheating. But this is, it's the wrong timing, man. It's the wrong timing because, you know, I hope it's just overheating because, man, I don't know what the rule is. Maybe somebody can help me out, man. Somebody can tell me, man, what's the rule if a candidate passes away in a presidential race? Can somebody please inform me on that shit? Can somebody let me know what's going down if two candidates are running for presidency and one of them dies during the presidency? What happens? Can somebody please Google the shit? Somebody, like, tell me. Somebody inbox a nigga or something. I want to know what happens, man, because I'm not going to say she's going to pass, and I hope she doesn't. But understand that, you know what I mean? Like, this shit's so crazy out here. Ain't no telling what the fuck's going to go down, man. The only thing you can do is kind of just be prepared. You understand what I'm saying? And that's what you got to do that, people. You got to do that. You know what I'm saying? And everybody's making a big deal about, you know, what these elections are going to mean and what's going to happen. And like I said, man, people think that Hillary Clinton is going to be a better choice than Donald Trump. But understand that Hillary Clinton was a part of Bill Clinton's presidency as far as, you know, just being a first lady. And I mean, she had other, you know, titles and duties and shit. But she also was around when Bill Clinton tripled the amount of black African-American incarcerations in the industrial prison system. You understand what I'm saying? So we got to be careful with what's going on out here. We got to be careful with this voting shit, man. I think that this year right here should be a year that people don't vote. This year, this presidential election coming up, people should not vote. Read my motherfucking lips. People should not vote. None. Motherfucking, it should be, the presidency should be handled by a million people should vote. And that million people vote for whoever the fuck. That's what needs to happen. Because I'm going to tell you this shit right here, man. It's crazy. So, you know, be careful with this shit out here, people. Y'all got to, you know, we got the what Pac say, we got busters, hoes, and police watching. You know what I'm saying? And, by the way, you know what I'm saying? Shout out to Tupac Shakur. Tupac, you know what I mean? This is, it's getting close to, the night that he got, I think it might have passed, man. I know it was in September. I don't know if it was September 11th, though, but I know that he passed in September around this time. It might be here in the next couple of days, but you know what I'm saying? On the weekend, I'm going to celebrate that shit. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to celebrate it with a little drink. Celebrate with a little, you know what I mean? You know what I mean? You know what I mean? So, shout out to Tupac, man. You know what I'm saying? Rest in peace, my nigga. We gonna try to, you know what I mean? I definitely ride with Pac every day. I let Pac ride in my shit every day. Nah, I ain't gonna bullshit. I try to let Pac ride in my shit. But, you know, sometimes, you know, shit don't happen. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah. So, you know what I'm saying? Hold on. Oh, so the coasting came back. The coasting came back. 21-17. No. Detroit. 9 minutes in the third quarter. That's what's up. You know, I had to say something to, you know what I'm saying, about the Indianapolis shit. I don't know. Now, I just got this in. I just looked at this on CNN. Oh, shit. Let me see if I can get this back. Alexis Arquette. I know the Arquette name. That Arquette last name sounds real familiar. She was an actress, and they had to include a transgender activist, even though I believe this is a woman. She recently just passed. She died today, man. So let me show y'all what's going on.
Really common for people to believe that it's all right to ask really uncomfortable questions to transgender people.
So people ask you lots of uncomfortable questions.
Absolutely. I mean, that's above and beyond, you know, things people say in the street who you don't know.
And bad things?
Yeah, and also if you're meeting somebody that you know and they're, it's not a bad thing, they feel often that it's okay to ask you if you're pre-op or these questions are... I mean, really, there's only one reason to ask about what's in someone's pants or skirt. And that's not to discriminate against them, certainly.
Okay, let's get away from that a bit and talk about the issue of being a celebrity and undergoing this procedure. Does that make it more difficult?
I don't think it's more difficult for people who are either raised in families of celebrities or celebrities themselves. I think, if anything, we've been prepared to deal with press and media. But I think it's more an exposing type thing because it's not about your work. It's not about what you want to contribute as an entertainer or your family has. It's only about your very personal identity issue.
May I ask you how your family reacted?
You know, the thing is, I was in a pretty liberal family. I mean, I wore makeup since I was 12, but they weren't in denial so much as their fear was that if I came out as transgender and lived my life as a woman, that I might receive a lot of flack from people on the street, and
has been okay.
Even violent.
Has it been okay?
I think, you know, anybody who's seen my reality show called Surreal Life would know that I have a hard time always holding back when it comes to my anger towards people's unacceptance of those who are different.
Damn. All right, well, I guess it was a transgender. I didn't know that they were transgender. You understand what I'm saying? I know you see the Arquette family, you know what I'm saying? One of them was in Scream movie, and I didn't know that was... But they died. They died, man. They was 47. They died, man. I just, you know what I'm saying, figured out. Now, the reason why I bring that up, man, the reason why I share that, man, is because, you know, we definitely at a state right now where if you black, man, you ain't got no rights, man. And transgender people, I don't have nothing against transgender people, but they have more rights than black people right now. You understand what I'm saying? Transgender people, shit, they was gonna make their own bathrooms, you know what I'm saying, out there on the East Coast, and it didn't happen. But yeah, should be mad and have an anger. Yeah, transgender with an anger problem, that's crucial, my nigga. That's crucial. You right, Snoop. Yeah. A motherfucking transgender with anger problems. What kind of shit is that, man? Who gonna wanna like that whole world, man, that whole world, even those that are gay, especially females that are gay, that have kids. That's a whole subject for a whole nother time, but women that have kids and now that are gay, or some women that be talking like, I may end up going gay, I may go gay. Okay, so women, if you go gay, man, and you got kids, man, how do you think that shit's going to be better in that relationship? And I'm going to tell you why, because a lot of gay women I see, black gay women, they go be with women that look like dudes. I'm talking about some stud women that look like niggas. I'm talking about they got low haircuts and sports bras that are pushing their titties down, and they wearing little necklaces and chains and shit. And it's like, shit, man, you know what I'm saying? Then they talk shit like, damn, why can't you just be gay and with this, you know what I'm saying, hard ass chick? Why you gotta be gay and mad and looking like a dude, you know what I'm saying? Because if you do that to a regular old nigga off the street, he gonna wanna fight you, you know what I'm saying? And then he gonna have to figure out, you know what I'm saying, you know, what to do because you a female. And then how he gonna know, you know what I mean? He gonna know the very last second when you're fighting, and he, you know, may grab your shirt, trying to throw you down and take your shirt off, and then all of a sudden some titties pop out. Like, what are you supposed to do, nigga? Like, what is supposed to happen? You know what I'm saying? I ain't never gotten into a fight with no stud. But if I get into a fight with a stud, I'm tearing their shirts off, man. I wanna see how big their titties are, man. I'm not gonna lie. Yeah, I wanna. That was probably fucked up. Nah, I don't want to see that shit. But you know what I'm saying? It's like, that shit crazy, man. A lot of studs be out here like they dudes and shit. And it's like, nigga, slow that shit down, please. Don't get it twisted. Don't get it fucked up, please. So we got to be careful out here, man. We got to be careful, and we got to know what's going on. Like I said, man, we ain't really got rights and shit. We ain't got no rights. We ain't got no constitutional rights. And the shit's just getting more and more crazy with these cops, man. We gotta figure out what to do. Let's see, man. Hold on, man. It's crazy, man. You be on Facebook, man. Facebook be on some I ain't been in Facebook jail in a while. You know what I mean? I don't want to go back to Facebook jail. Has anybody ever been in Facebook jail? Shit crazy, B. Shit crazy. You can go to Facebook jail and be in Facebook jail for like a week or two, nigga. You can't even share shit. You can't do none of that shit. I'm looking on, I'm looking on Facebook right now, man, just to fuck around. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Damn, man, I ain't got this coat. This coat game. What's this? She knocked the watch. She's who like the nigga they close to. Oh, yeah? Nah, I ain't know that. I ain't know studs are posting Facebook fights out here. I ain't know that shit. For real? See if I can find one. So this is what I like about Facebook Live, man. You know what I'm saying? Working off, you know what I'm saying? A few things, man, where I can, you know, show videos along with what I'm, you know, what's going on and shit. You know what I mean? Hold on, let's see. I ain't really about watching shit, you know, black people fighting all the goddamn time, which is really through, you know, World Star and shit like that, but, well, let's see here, we got a stud versus a dyke fight. Oh, shit. Now, you know, these are some very athletic studs and dykes, man. Now, I'm just about to show a little bit of this shit, man. You know, I can't watch too much of this shit. Look how athletic that motherfucking stud is, man. Look how athletic. Damn, man. Watching that type of shit. Watching that type of video right there, man. They like they can whoop some niggas ass, man. They like they can whoop some men. I ain't gonna say men because a lot of these niggas ain't men out here. A lot of these niggas are males. But they like they can fight some males. You know what I'm saying? But see, I ain't gonna lie, man. You know what I mean? I ain't even trying to fight no gay person, man, to be honest with you, because you know what I'm saying? I kind of treat gay, especially gay dudes. I treat gay dudes like they could possibly have superhuman strength. You know what I'm saying? Only reason being is because, you know, the way it is right now, you know what I mean? There's a lot of things that people can do to manipulate the estrogen and the testosterone in their body. So it's like if you a dude and you trying to be a female, you can do some things to manipulate your body and include those things in your body and create a real imbalance of yourself. You understand what I'm saying? So it's like, you know what I mean? I don't really fuck with none of these gay dudes out here on many levels. Pause. But I damn sure ain't about to fight none of these niggas, man. For the simple fact that, you know what I'm saying, the embarrassment of getting beat up by a gay dude that's not that I can't put that on my resume. You know what I'm saying? I can't just fight a gay dude, get beat up by a gay dude, and think that's gonna be cool. I can damn near never show my face again, son. I had to change my name, my whole I had to change everything if that happened. You understand what I'm saying? So, you know what I mean? Be careful, man. That's all I'm going to say. Keep being, I'm going to keep saying to the people, be cautious out here. Please, man. You know what I'm saying? Matter of fact, homie. Make sure I ain't, about to get attacked by, you know what I mean? Oh, shit. Let's see, what else, man? What's going on in the what's going on in the world, man? We still getting, like I said, we still getting fucked up by the police. You know what I mean? The police is still beating the shit out of us, killing us and shit. You know, those that were on, you know, looked on the news, you know, you had the incident that happened in Milwaukee where, you know what I mean, you had a black cop shoot a black dude. Now, the black dude was armed, and I think he was legally armed, but the nigga started running, and the black cop got the shooting at him and shot him in the back. And, you know what I'm saying, it's already been some crazy shit going on. And, oh, by the way, it's still protests going on in Ferguson, all right? Shout-outs to Ferguson, motherfucking, in St. Louis. Shouts out to Ferguson, man. They still getting it in up there. I recently briefly spoke about the activist that passed away in St. Louis. Actually, he got killed. Hold on, let me see if I can. I can't remember the brother's name right now. Maybe somebody in the chat room can help me out. What's the brother's name that just got executed out there in St. Louis? What's his name? Cameron Hernandez, what up? What up, man? Somebody help me out, man. What's the dude's name? What's the dude's name that just died in St. Louis? Hold on, I'll find it. What's the dude's name? The dude that just died in St. Louis. He was an activist. They end up shooting him in the car. They shot him in the car and lit his car on fire. I just kind of heard about this. Darren Seals, that's his name. Darren Seals. Dude, he was in St. Louis and Ferguson. You know what I'm saying? He was an activist, a real activist, hardcore, you know what I mean? Going to City Hall, going down to the Congress, going down to the areas and working with the Bloods and Crips out there in St. Louis, man, to get them, you know, on one accord. And, you know, he was really doing his thing out there. And recently, I believe this was last week, he died, man. They killed him. And when I say they, it wasn't no motherfucking black on black they. You understand what I'm saying? It was those that you know, on that supremacy shit. That's who killed him, you know what I mean? I'm gonna say it right now. You be like, Jay Scott, how you know? You wasn't there, you ain't got no proof. Nigga, you can look what the fuck, you can just see and read some of the shit that went down. And if y'all don't know, a lot of people that have gotten killed, black people that have gotten killed, they've had lawsuits against the police. You understand what I'm saying? They've had lawsuits and they've sued the police. And I'm talking about everybody from Sandra Bland. You know, there's a few people, damn near all of them. I think Eric Garner might have sued the police. Just about a majority of the black people that have died in the hands or the custody of the police that were black all had some type of situation with the police, man. They all wanted to, you know, do something against the police as far as suing them. You know, everyone had a case. Just about everybody, like the dude I just mentioned in Milwaukee that got killed, he had a case against the police. You understand what I'm saying? He sued them, or, you know, it's real out here, man. So just because you hear about what's the other female, the female that was in Baltimore, her last name was Gaines, light skinned female. She had even though they pub, you know, they make her seem like she was like a vigilante, crazy ass black woman that had a shootout with the police. She had a lawsuit against Baltimore police. So these are not coincidences, people. This is the real deal, man. People that have been targeted and try to go, you know, and get some type of justice from the police, they getting killed. And it's just no joke, man. So, you know, rest in peace, you know what I'm saying, to the brother out there in St. Louis, man, you know, Darren Seals. You know what I mean? He was really doing this thing out there. I seen a video where they were all in the streets and the police were basically doing their tactical procedures where they try to back people down and they were trying to get people into the same area, like a circle, and they were trying to circle the people in, and them niggas was like, nah, nigga, we know what y'all doing. Y'all can get the fuck out of here, and the police left. So it's like, you know what I mean, we just gotta know what the fuck's going on out here. Yeah, back to football, man. So, the Dallas Cowboys are playing today. They're playing right now. And the reason why I bring that up is because the running back that plays for Dallas, he went to Ohio State, Ezekiel Elliott. He had recently got into the news because he had went to a weed dispensary, I believe in Seattle, before they played a preseason game. And they cleared him of that. He didn't get in trouble. But then I found out and I looked up. Somehow he was getting ready to have a domestic abuse case. And let's see, I think I found a video for it. I didn't really know this shit. Okay, hold on.
You know, it's not a day that goes by that a certain people.
That's his girl. First of all, man, I would like to say that the video clips I show do not reflect the views of comedian J. Scott. Some of them do. All right? I'm not going to bullshit you. Some of them do. Some of these videos I will show you do reflect comedian J. Scott's opinion. But this right here, I'm just going to go ahead and throw that disclaimer out there. All right, so I'm just going to watch a little bit. You know what I'm saying?
As I said before, I don't follow a lot of sports like I used to because it just ain't the same, and I don't want to contribute to that, to the exploitation of a lot of these players. And I know y'all say exploitation, These guys are millionaires. Let me say this again. These guys are making millions. The owners are making billions. And when you look at the grand scheme of these guys, don't have anything after much to do after they sports career, but try to be a commentator. Now, they don't hire these guys to be coaches or anything. These guys can't go buy a team because they're going to shut them out to keep from buying a team. Ex-Walter Payton Widow when Walter tried to buy a football team. But anyways, I come across an article. And the first thing I want to say to my subs who sent me these links, thank you. Like I said, I don't go all around the internet a lot of times looking for certain things. There's certain websites that I don't know about. Well, let me read this to y'all. Right from the beginning, it seemed that Dallas Cowboys running back Ezekiel Elliott was the victim in a fraudulent scheme to destroy his credibility, and his career by ex-girlfriend was unhappy about him moving on. Tiffany Thompson claimed that Elliott beat her, even provided pictures via Instagram as proof she was beaten. But at least four witnesses on the scene had already told investigators that nothing the victim said was true because they witnessed the entire incident. Now you see this Caucasian female, this kid, I'm assuming she's Caucasian. But for this all intents and purposes, looking at the pictures of her skin, she's Caucasian. She got into a bar fight with another woman. And she said, told Ezekiel, if you break it off of me, I'm going to ruin you. Now let me tell you something. I keep saying this to my sisters, Gabrielle Union, and some of you other well-known Hollywood women, you top-head females. Y'all running to defend these white females, the same females that y'all get mad when brother gets with, but y'all standing with them when they allow them are known liars. Now there gonna be white people coming to my job and say, "Harvey, you reverse racist," but white women have that history.
All right, man, that's all I'm gonna show her that. But hey, you know that was some real shit though. There's a lot of real history behind that. You understand what I'm saying? I didn't know it was a fake story that, you know what I mean? I didn't know she was getting ready to accuse him of sexual domestic abuse. I didn't know she was getting ready to do that. I didn't know none of that shit. I just know I saw that shit and I said, man, damn, they done got another nigga again. God damn. I don't get it. It's like, look, man, you can date who you want to date. And I get all that, but if you date who you want to date, you just got to understand the history. You got to understand the history of black men and white females. You have to understand the history. That's what I just played that clip from. That's what he was talking about briefly. You got to do the history, man. Like, you know, I got a buddy. Well, I don't know if he's a buddy of mine anymore. I'm not even going to say his name. But he's married to a white female, and I'm pretty sure she's a cool person. But the reason why this nigga married her wasn't because, in my opinion, it was about some real true interest and love. The problem was that this nigga ended up getting railroaded by a chick that basically used to be a turned out, used to be a bust wide open thought ass chick. And I'm coding all this shit because I still know these motherfuckers. And one of them may still be on my goddamn Facebook page, which I don't give a fuck. But I'm going to say it anyway. He married her and then end up, you know what I'm saying, getting railroaded. You know what I mean? By this chick. You know what I mean? Had a kid by her. Sorry. Had a kid by her and end up, you know, getting mentally, emotionally, physically drained. Played, abused, basically, yeah, by a female, but that's because this nigga thought he was in love. You understand what I'm saying? So what he did was, this nigga took that situation and basically put all black women into a bottle. You know what I'm saying? And you know, there's things that black men and black women need to handle first before someone can say, "I need to go date someone outside my race." That's my personal opinion. But I'm going off of history. You understand what I'm saying? We have to be able to do that and dissect that and actually process that shit before you can actually want to say, "I'm going to be in an interracial relationship." You got to understand that 40, 50 years ago, while you know, the age of your parents and grandparents, people could not fucking walk the streets and even look at a white person, let alone a white woman. Look at Emmett Till. Emmett Till got fucking his face fucked up and was I unidentifiable. Yeah, I said it, unidentifiable. Because he supposedly looked at a white woman or whistled at a white woman. We gotta be serious out here with this shit, man. Like, people have to really understand and be focused, man. You gotta know your history, man. You gotta know, you know what I'm saying, your history between black men and white women. You gotta understand, just like the part of that clip I showed you, white women have done this for a long time, man. A lot of white women can claim any type of anything against a black man, and that black man has the potential to go to jail and possibly go to prison. You understand what I'm saying? You can look at all different types of cases of that shit happening. And for old boy Ezekiel Elliott, nigga, and a lot of these football players, man, they fucks with white chicks, man. They fucks with white chicks heavy, bruh. You understand what I'm saying? They fucks with white chicks heavy, nigga. All right, shouts out to Kitchmel County in the chat. Shouts out to DJ Freeney and my cousin John motherfucking Silas. What up, nigga? But yeah, you know what I'm saying? I'm not gonna be on here much longer, you know what I mean? I'm surprised you Facebook even let me go this far with the shit. Sorry. But yeah, somebody, if anybody in the chat right now, man, if they know a good podcast system to kind of work off of, let a nigga know, man. I'm trying to get my podcast on. You understand what I'm saying? It'd be good to find a podcast to where I can get the visual in too. Hopefully this live clip right here, I can hopefully upload it to YouTube. So I'm trying to upload it later. That's why I'm going on pretty long right here. You know what I mean? Because I've gotten to the point where, you know what I mean, I'm not trying to do long ass 2-3 hour shows. That's just too much. You understand what I'm saying? Unless it's just some nice little fire game and shit that I want to, you know, get it in with, then I'll go a little longer. But, you know, I kind of just want to keep things kind of short and sweet right now as I feel my way back into the live stream and social commentary role, you know what I mean, in the world. Yeah, John, I know you see my mustache is growing back quick, nigga. I know my mustache was looking kind of crazy last week, but, why you gotta, Nigga, your government name is on your profile picture, nigga. That's your profile name, nigga. But yeah, man, hey, if you know what I mean, John, anybody else in here, man, If you know a podcast, broadcasting, you know what I mean, where I can actually broadcast off a podcast, if you know a link or something, man, send that to me. You know, if you know me, can you send it? If you know me, can you send me a link to one of these podcasts, man? Podcast links so I can put the podcast up, you know what I'm saying? I've been searching, but you know, I got this Apple shit, man, so it's kind of fucked up, man, on how you find shit on fucking Apple. But if you know a link, send that link to me, man. If you know me, text that shit to me, son. Or email that shit. If you don't know me, send me the link on Facebook or something, please. You know, help a brother out, man. I would appreciate that shit, you feel me? Let's see, what else, man? But yeah, that football shit's real, you know? Ezekiel Elliott, nigga, I hope you learned your lesson. I hear the game popping off, so I don't know. I DVR'd it, so I may go back and watch that shit. Hey, man, this nigga John, man. He must be drunk, nigga. But yeah, you know what I mean? Ezekiel Elliott, man, I hope you learned your lesson, my nigga. I'm pretty sure you probably haven't. But I hope you get that shit right You know what I mean? I want to, before I get up out of here, man, you know what I mean, since we've been kind of talking about the NFL, I want to play a clip. I want to play a clip from this NFL show that had, I think it's NFL Live, not NFL Live, it's one of these NFL shows that had Brandon Marshall on there. And Brandon Marshall, it was Brandon Marshall, the black dude, James Brown. Yeah, that's his name, James Brown. Not the singer, but you know what I mean, the sports commentary. They were on a show. They had Brandon Marshall on a show. And I want to see if I can try to find it, because I wanted to play it because I wanted you all to kind of just hear the answers that were given. Not the answers, but just the commentary that was said, with Boomer Esiason, who is a former quarterback, and Phil Simms. So I want to see if I can find that shit, because that shit kind of shows you. Hold on, let me see if I can find it. Damn, sound like somebody done scored, man. I'm watching it. Got this. Here it go. Now, this is a pretty long clip. You know what I'm saying? But what I want to do is, man, when you watch this shit, man, just make sure when you watch it, make sure you pay attention to Boomer Esiason. You know what I mean? He was a quarterback that played, I believe he played in the late 80s, early 90s, and has Brandon Marshall, wide receiver for the New York Jets. He's got James Brown on there, who was a commentator. And Phil Simms, who was another former quarterback. But just watch this shit, man. Just look at what Boomer Esiason is saying, man. And you got two black people and two white people on the show, and the whole topic is about race. Now, just peep this shit out, man.
Well, as kickoff weekend quickly approaches, there is one topic that's been dominating the headlines, and of course, it has been transcending the football field. That is the stance taken by San Francisco 49ers quarterback Colin Kaepernick, not to stand for our national anthem. And we're going to try to just make this an organic conversation. And let me be clear, we're all friends. We've worked together a long time. We like each other. We have different opinions on a number of things. And this is a hot button topic that cannot be held in diverse groups. Hasn't been held enough around the country with diverse groups,
correct?
The optics, black and white folk talking together about it, no matter what your opinion is, so that we can advance things with respect to that. We don't need to have these conversations, and I was using the polite word, homogenous groups. All black folk talking, all white folk talking, all liberals talking, all conservatives. We need to hear each other, and what needs to be the operating one, and it's really me, because I know I feel passionate about the subject as well, too, that love ought to undergird the conversation. I kept using the example of Martin Luther King leading the civil rights movement. He told the followers, they cannot react. They need to show love. And when people of good conscience saw how inhumanely people were being treated, that's when people of all colors and stripes got together. These are very, very tough topics and very difficult situations to discuss, because there are different reasons why different people get offended. People may get offended by me because they don't understand how I see the world. And I will explain that here. What I want for everybody is I want happiness. I want love. I want you to be able to take your family on vacations. I want you to be able to have of what living in the United States is all about.
Now, I'm going to say this right quick, man. Cut this shit right quick. White people, anybody white, if you white right now, if you a white person, you a Caucasian, if you consider yourself a Caucasian person from the mountains of the Caucasus, if you a white person and you listening to this right now, stop trying to sell black people the American dream. Stop, nigga. Stop trying to sell black people the American dream. That's the thing. We have to try to assimilate to get that acceptance to live the American dream. I'm gonna say it again. We have to assimilate to feel the acceptance of wanting to be a part of the American dream. Okay? Stop that shit, please, please, please. I mean, it's crucial, man. Just stop that shit. Stop trying to sell niggas a dream, man. Just stop it, yo.
And that is making something for yourself and becoming great at it, which I'd like to think all four of us have been afforded that opportunity because of the way that we live our lives. I believe when I see the American flag, I live with great pride when I see that. You know, my father was a World War II veteran. My godfather was on the USS Nevada. You know, it was bombed by the Japanese. And both of them made it out of World War II. So I grew up in a family that was very patriotic, that understood what that flag stood for. It may be different for other people. So when I see somebody like Colin Kaepernick in an NFL...
Man, just watch how. Just watch this shit, man. Just watch this shit.
...uniform on an NFL field, not respect that flag. I'm not saying that he doesn't respect the military, but just not stand for that flag. That really bothers me. And I really feel like he's insulted the flag. And the initial rhetoric...
That's another thing. Do research, people. Do your research, because that motherfucking flag didn't always have stars and stripes and shit all on it, alright? The American flag... First of all, the American flag was used for war. You understand what I'm saying? And I don't know how the fuck these people be trying to incorporate the American flag with football, man. You know what I'm saying? Now, on a deeper level, I understand why the American flag and the whole military narrative is pushed upon in the NFL game. Because, you know what I'm saying? I understand that. This shit's like on some gladiator shit. Some Titans shit when they have these stadiums full of football players that basically come from slavery and are basically considered to be super nigga slaves that are playing football. All right, understand all that shit. But let's not get it twisted, man. The military, when it comes to having to do with the football game, is that a lot of these football positions used to be old military positions. Alright? That's what the fuck it is. I was thinking about that shit for a long time. What the fuck does the military have to do with the NFL? Excuse me. Especially with this Colin Kaepernick shit. What does it have to do with the military? Why are they bringing the military into him shitting on the flag? Well, that's because the military used to use these positions on the football field as positions of war. Understand? Got it.
That was coming from Colin and wearing the pig socks on the practice field really bothered me.
That came out after.
But I already knew a lot of that stuff. So the thing about it is that, you know, I don't like rogue cops any more than anybody else does. I hate corrupt politicians. I hate anybody who goes and does the wrong thing. They should be held accountable, put in jail, sued, whatever you want to call it.
Man, you know, sorry to cut you off, but what I find really interesting, and to me, I feel like I'm...
That's because he cut him off, man. He cut them off. But see, also, man, I want you to pay attention, man, to how they speak, because they talk about how they don't want these things to happen to people. Well, the reason why you're saying that is because it ain't never happened to your ass.
One of the most incredible people to speak on this topic, because I grew up in Pittsburgh, and that was the poorest county in Pennsylvania. And I also moved to Orlando, Florida, where I was the only black guy in our neighborhood, black family in our neighborhood. So I seen both ends of the spectrum. So I see it both ways, and I'm able to understand and validate both sides. But what I don't understand is, before Colin Kaepernick knelt or sat before the flag, there was only one other white athlete that stood up and said, you know what, this is wrong. This is a human rights issue. This is a civil rights issue. But soon as the flag got involved, which is the distraction, it's not the message, Everyone ran to this conversation and gave their thoughts.
That flag means a lot to a lot of people and a lot of families.
But you talk about this, you talk about the flag, and when I see the flag, I see the same thing. Like for you, you just explain what it means to you, and you're really proud of it, and I think you should be proud of it. But the flag to me represents a bunch of fights. The flag to me represents what America has overcome. When Colin Kaepernick comes out and say these are the two things of the flag that I disagree with, and we need to get right. I think it was the perfect timing and the perfect place to get the conversation started to push it forward, because if it saves one life.
You see how Boomer Esiason is doing all that moving and shit, and then soon as Marshall cut him off, and Boomer was like, this nigga just cut me off, son? Fuck this nigga, man. Give me my coffee, bitch. This is crazy.
It's worth it.
Well, that's right, because you can't put a price on anybody's life. Here's what I will say about this, and nobody knows this better than I do, because I've taken the platform of being an NFL quarterback and being somebody that's on television and raised millions of dollars, over $100 million, in fact, in the fight against cystic fibrosis, the disease my son has. I know you have been an advocate for mental health. You've taken that platform, but we haven't done it on the field. We've done it off the field, and that's what...
And you see, man, he's trying to bring in something that really ain't got shit to do with shit. Yeah. Brandon Marshall has done a lot of work for mental disorder, which is good. Boomer Esiason is doing something for the for cystic fibrosis. How you say that shit, man? But just keep watching this shit, great, man.
I lauded Carmelo Anthony when he went down to Baltimore. Why? Because he went down there, he calmed the situation, he let the people in Baltimore know, where he grew up, by the way, that people are listening. We hear you. And just his presence, his credibility, his name led voices to what they are arguing about or want justice in their eyes. When I saw Carmelo Anthony, Chris Paul, and Dwayne Wade, and LeBron James standing on that stage at the ESPYs, there was four guys with all the credibility in the world to speak of what they were speaking of.
Off the court.
Yeah, but still.
Just like what he said, off the motherfucking court. Them niggas didn't do that shit when they was on the court.
The court, but standing in front because they built the brand. Everybody knows who they are. They have the credibility to do that. Just like Colin Kaepernick as a former Super Bowl quarterback, if he wants to get involved in a particular social issue like this, he can do that away from
the field. But I said it earlier, Boom. I said we are institutionalized as players. And I'll say this to you. You are institutionalized. And the reason why is because the NFL has told us, okay, this is our culture. Players be players. You're retired now. You still have that same sentiment that players need to just... Football field, this is sacred territory. It's a football field. It's a jersey. The NFL, they're monetizing us. We're walking billboards for them. Well, the NFL has used the playing field... The NFL has used the playing for breast cancer awareness over the last 10 years.
Wow.
The military, honoring the veterans. But a player, it can't be an individual and say, oh, I can't wear... My shoes for mental health awareness or cystic fibrosis or Black Lives Matter or White Lives Matter.
Could you imagine with the amount of players and the amount of points of view in the NFL, if everybody was allowed to go on the field and do whatever they want or act any way that they want?
It would be a show. It would be a zoo. Yeah, but we can't have a double standard. We can't tell our players, hey, which the NFL is made up of 75% Black people, African Americans. We can't tell our players, hey, this is what we're going to honor. This is what we're going to do. And on the other end, when we try to do something as an individual, say, no, you stay in that box.
I think it's great.
Now, yeah. There you have it, people. You understand what I'm saying? I salute Brandon Marshall, man. You know, he did his thing on that show. I want to play another clip, man, but I'll probably just gonna get up off this shit, man. I'll probably, you know, follow back up next week with this other clip, man. This nigga Ray Lewis, man. Fuck it. Let's do it right now, man. This nigga Ray Lewis, now I don't know if you know about Ray Lewis, man, but Ray Lewis used to play for the Baltimore Ravens. You know, he was a good-ass football player, but I'm going to tell you, man, Ray Lewis has become one of the biggest motherfucking coons, man. He is on a coon movement. Now, I don't know if you've paid attention to Ray Lewis, which I'm pretty sure you haven't, but he's done videos inside his house. And the last video he did inside his house, man, he was trying to sound like a preacher. And he was like, I know that you're out here killing each other in the streets on some black-on-black crime. We need to stop that shit. And he was like doing all that type of shit. I'm like, what the fuck is wrong with Ray Lewis, man? Now, so I'm going to end this on this. Now, that last clip I showed you, some real shit. You see how Boomer Esiason, how he started feeling all like uptight and shit when Brandon Marshall was cutting him off and all that. Well, this clip right here is basically from the show called Undisputed, which has Skip Bayless and Shannon Sharp, who, you know, Shannon Sharp used to play in the game in for a minute. And he actually, you know, talks, you know, pretty good on here, man. I thought he was a coon for a long time, too. But he actually, you know, he actually saying some real shit. Now, this nigga Ray Lewis, see how Ray Lewis comes on this show and basically start trying to enter in the black-on-black shit, black-on-black crime when it comes to Colin Kaepernick doing the shit for the American flag.
Shannon, what is your reaction to Goodell's comments?
Well, I'm glad he commented on it, and I'm glad I know where he stands on this topic. The commissioner is looking at it from a point like, I'm a patriot, I love patriotism, I love the values and the freedoms that this country provides. Well, Colin Kaepernick, in that sense, is a patriot, because he said, although I've been very successful, although there we've come a long way, I believe we can have a better society. You know, people, and this is what I don't understand, is that people will take, say, let's just say for the sake of argument, 1,000 athletes or entertainers, and say, well, what are black people complaining about? Well, there's 34 million African Americans, or the minorities. I've never heard anyone say, well, the LBG community is not being discriminated against because Ellen DeGeneres has her own show. She's making millions. No one ever said, well, women get 78 to 83 cents on the dollar compared to a man because Meg Whitman is a billionaire. But they only say that about African Americans because you see a Ray Lewis or a Shannon Sharp played in the National Football League on television, or Magic Johnson or Michael Jordan. But the one, the greatest one, you got President Obama in the White House. So America ain't racist. Stop it. And America has always had a problem with racism. It's, I think now it's because of the cell phone, because it's captured more and it's in your face. We don't have to wait to 6 o'clock to see it, not Skip.
Yep.
You do it, it's up on the internet.
See that nigga Ray Lewis chomping at the bit to get the cooning, man. He chomping at the bit, nigga.
Up on the internet right now. Commissioner, I believe Commissioner has a right to say what he says, but the First Amendment is a beautiful thing, unless you don't agree with the gesture. But you should be uncomfortable. Protest should make you uncomfortable, and it should come with consequences. So if Colin, if this 49er says, Colin, we're going to suspend you for 3 games, so be it. He's getting his point across, because Muhammad Ali, all the greats that's taken a stand, John Carlos and Tommy Smith, they took a stand. They could have waited till they come home, but it would not have served the same purpose. Well, wait till he get out of the uniform. No, it wouldn't serve the same purpose. We want you to be uncomfortable. We want you to come to the table and talk intelligently.
So are you criticizing the commissioner's stance on this?
I wish he'd had a more positive spin. He's making it seem like Colin Kaepernick isn't a patriot. This was never about the flag. Mm-hmm. This was never about the veterans. Right. He told you what it was about, but you still keep trying to take it back there.
And you see how they're throwing the flag for the distraction. That's all that shit is, man. It's a distraction, man. Fucking flag and football. What the fuck the shit?
But you don't want to talk about the issues in which Colin Kaepernick is raping.
Yeah, listen, I'm when you think about what Colin has did, right? The only thing that I think about the most is Muhammad Ali, yes. Jim Browns, all of these guys. If you come out with this type of stand, the most important thing next is a solution. You must have a solution.
Yes.
Because if you don't have a solution, then we're just protesting for nothing, right?
Right, yeah.
So when Colin comes out and does what he does, if Colin calls, Shay, and you know this,
yes.
If Colin calls 50 to 100 guys around the league and say, man, listen, this is what I'm standing for,
right.
I guarantee you get a lot of them to follow you.
Right?
But sometimes when you go by yourself, the thing that happens is nobody understands what the deal is,
right,
until you start to actually get into it. So now you think about what Roger's stance is right now. Roger has the stance that says, listen, I get it, Colin, A lot of people stand, a lot of players stand for different things, but you got to understand what you're standing for. I don't think it's about the flag per se, right?
Yeah, what the fuck this nigga Ray Lewis talking about, man? Shit. This nigga doing a lot of fucking tap dancing, man. Shit, man. But the coonery's coming. The coonery's coming.
My only advice to Colin Kaepernick is this. Listen, I understand what you're trying to do. But understand, take the flag out of it. Right?
Take the flag out of it.
I got uncles. I got brothers who walked out of my house, going into the military, that said, I will never see you again. To understand that, I will always respect that part of what our patriotism should be, right? And that's the side that I think if Colin really just steps back, because to effect change, right, to effect true change, and what he's trying to say, if you don't have a real solution, if you ain't seen as a true activist to go into these hoods and do these things on a daily basis and not just jump up and just protest off this one thing because you're sick of it, we've been sick of racism for 400 plus years. But we won't.
Now, I'm going to tell you, man, Ray Lewis, Ray Lewis is doing what you call coding shit, all right? Because he's saying some pretty, you know, vital things. He's saying some things that are real, all right? So you got to be able to learn how to dissect this shit, all right? So Ray Lewis is talking that shit, and he's talking real shit now. Let's not get it twisted. Ray Lewis is saying some real things, all right? Now, you hear what he's saying. Now, let me know when you know when the coonery is getting ready to come in. Or when you hear the coonery.
Our counterparts to acknowledge it and not sweep it under the rug and tell us it's a figment of my imagination. Right. And not tell me because we have a black president, everything's okay. Mm-hmm. And because Michael Jordan is a billionaire, it's okay. Because Oprah are billionaires, and because we see some blacks on TV that have success, everything in our community, everything in the LBG community is okay, because it's not okay.
Right.
But you have to understand this, and what the commission must understand also, is the flag doesn't represent all things to all people the exact same way. Okay. And that's what he's trying to do. If that flag represents freedoms and liberties, I should have freedoms and liberty. And just like his First Amendment, that he has the right to do that, to just say, okay, Colin, I think you should have found another way. What other way is we say, don't riot. They say, we're going to do it peacefully. Okay, we're going to just take a knee. But don't protest like that. If you tell me how I should protest, you're kind of minimalizing and weakening what I can do, because you're not trying to hear me. You keep what they keep trying to do. The argument that Colin is making, they keep trying to take it back to spot. They keep taking it back to the flag.
Right.
They keep taking it back to the veterans. Let's talk about the issues,
right,
that what Colin is trying to draw attention to, and then we can get some of our better leaders. Let's get some of our better leaders and say, okay, guys, but we got to have the counterparts, dude. We got to have them at the table, because having Dr. Michael Eric Dyson or Roland Martin as some of our foremost thinkers in our community, Dr. Harry Edwards, it's not me sitting around a table with a bunch of black guys ain't going to solve anything. Until we get a bunch of white guys that's in position of authority that can really affect change.
Yeah.
Because Dr. King's civil rights movement was great, but it wasn't until the whites came on our side and said, you know what, this is wrong.
I got you.
And once they did that...
Shannon Sharp was starting to coon a little bit right there, man. I fucked with Shannon Sharp, son! Even though the nigga got like 13 kids, I fucks with Shannon Sharp, man. But that nigga started to lose me with that shit. I'm going to tell you why, because you know what I'm saying? I'm all, like, black people, we love to have an inclusion. We love to include people in our struggle, man. We love to have this inclusion thing rather than trying to work it from the grassroots up and trying to have more of us do something collectively together as a people first. That's what I'd say about the whole interracial dating thing. We have to flush a lot of things out with ourselves within the black community so we can be able to allow white people to come in or allow others to come in and be a part of our movement and struggle. We can't be in some type of real struggle and real movement and then we trying to get it lifted, and we ain't lifted a real movement in a long time. We have to lift that movement and do it from ourselves together. And then we can include white people, Asian people, any person of other color We got to clean out what we doing first before we can start letting other people in, as even if we want to let them in our movement. You understand what I'm saying? So right there, hey, Mama Kishmel, I know you checking me out right now. You might hear some language that you might hear some language, but it's all good. Don't we good though?
Skip, he got legs.
Speaking of white guys, I am obviously one. And when Colin first sat...
Now, remember what I said, man. Remember, let me get back to the focus, man. Remember what I said about Ray Lewis, man. Ray Lewis was on here doing his thing, making some good points, saying some things that we need to know as people. But just keep watching this.
The anthem, I must admit, I told you before, and I'm telling you now, I cringed. I'm one nation under God. And I felt like I was already painfully aware of the issue he was trying to draw national attention to, which is that way too many unarmed black men are getting killed by white cops without retribution, without punishment.
Yes.
It's a staggering problem that our nation faces. And I'm begging, I begged Shannon the other day on our first show, just point me in the right direction. How do we fix this? I don't have a solution to it, to use your word.
It's not a short term, okay? Don't skip.
So then, 400 years I got it. But there's some fix. At least we're moving in the right direction. So then I opened my ears and my eyes to what Colin was saying. And he started to extremely impress me because as a kid quarterback, he was a little angry, chip on his shoulder, wouldn't talk to the media, kind of turned me off from him, even though I loved him as a player and often applauded him as a player on the show. But now I'm hearing a young man who's growing up because his last couple of interviews,
yes,
they've been mature, powerful, well-informed.
Yes.
He's talking to activists and advocates and he's asking for veterans to come talk to him. He is educating himself. It's almost like he has a whole second career going right now, which is this issue. He has brought great national attention to this issue. So all of a sudden, the season comes. And he does play in the National Football League that is run by Roger Goodell.
Right.
So Roger felt compelled to finally speak out. And he basically said, time out. Appreciate your stance, your First Amendment right. But this is our league. It's not yours. You're just blessed to be able to play. I put words in his mouth, but that's how it came across to me.
We understand.
You're blessed to play in our league, and I control our league. So I do believe in the uniform code, that it has to be sacred, that you can't put...
Now, you got to watch Skip Bayless, man. You know what I mean? You got to watch Skip Bayless, because Skip Bayless, you know what I mean? I'm not saying he's a white supremacist, but Skip Bayless, you know, he don't care at all. Skip Bayless don't give a damn at all. You understand what I'm saying? Skip Bayless, you know, recently just caught some flack because he tried to say that Troy Aikman, a football player that used to play for the Dallas Cowboys, he tried to say that Troy Aikman was gay. All right? So you got to understand, man, Skip Bayless is saying some things on here, but, you know, he codes a lot of things, and he knows kind of how to play the cards. You understand what I'm saying?
On your uniform or whatever your pause is, it's all got to be the same because we all love the National Football League. We're going to watch tonight, and we don't want to get distracted by various whatever's on the uniform. Maybe it's breast cancer. Who knows? They're all great causes, but you can't, you know, cloud the uniform.
Right.
You can't distract the fans from what they love, which
right.
is the football game. So I think finally he said, we've all got to do what we got to do in the anthem also, that we have to be patriots or whatever he's saying. He's just saying, this is our league, and we do have sponsors who don't like your protest,
mm-hmm, right.
and so we've got to do it this way. Is that fair to me? I mean, it's big business, and that's what he did. He just took a big business stand, right?
Yeah, right.
Does that make sense?
Yeah, but listen, but I think, understand the solution, right? And so I want people to really hear this, and you understand this, being on great teams, right? Being on great teams is the same thing, exactly what police officers must do. When you're on a great team, the top tier weed out the weaker tier, right? If somebody's doing something wrong in the locker room,
okay.
You didn't need nobody. You didn't need a coach to come tell me how to. We took care of that.
We took care of
and
that.
And in today's time, police must police
themselves, okay? I'm
because
like...
because if they're not policing themselves, then there's no way we could ever stop what's really going on, right? Because when you think about what's going on 400 years plus, the only thing that's changed is social media. The only thing that's changed is these things are actually captured now.
Right.
right? And now it's more of a sensitive issue because you're saying, how can that happen? But watch this. You think about, and so this is what I'm screaming, and I'm telling Colin, I'm applauding you. I'm applauding him for taking the stand for that.
Right.
But I'm also saying, if you look at CNN yesterday, a topic came out yesterday, 500 homicides in less than 9 months in one city in Chicago.
Right.
So the issue that we're talking about, Shay, is a much deeper issue.
It is. Okay, so wait a second. Right. So you're saying good cops in every police department must stand up and try to weed out the obvious racist cops.
Right. You know who's racist or not in your
age. You would know it. I promise you.
You would know it. If they speak to your family, you would know it. If they walk past your kids, you would know it.
Yep.
And that's the problem.
Black and white cops.
Absolutely.
Know it.
Because here's the thing. And when you talk about they will share that all cops are not bad. I understand that. But all blacks are not bad either.
Right.
So don't come with a preconceived notion because we committed crimes, or there's so many, some blacks commit crimes. Don't have no preconceived notion because you arrested one on the corner, you see me, that I'm just like him. Because if you want me to give you the benefit of the doubt, all I ask for is that same benefit of the doubt in return. That's all I ask.
All right, man, that's enough of that, man. So as you see, man, Ray Lewis, man, he had to throw in the black-on-black crime statistic. And, of course, he threw in the Chicago statistic, which is so clichéic right now. Anytime someone wants to talk about what's going on with the injustice of black people, anytime someone wants to co-sign and make it seem as if it's just about Chicago, and they use that as a prime example, you got to watch these niggas, man. Because they spitting out white supremacist rhetoric. That's what that is. When you hear Ray Lewis talk about, oh, check this out. Wait a minute. Check this out, dog. When he start doing all that, and now, I'm going to be honest with you. You do some research on them killings and shootings in Chicago, in my personal opinion, it's a lot of that's coming from the police, man. I refuse to believe that every holiday, why is it every holiday, it don't matter what holiday it is. It can be Easter, nigga. And it will be 60, 70 shootings in Chicago and nobody may die. That 60, 70 shootings every holiday, man. Every single holiday that I've seen in the past 2, 3, 4, 5 years, it's always been some type of big ass shootings in Chicago. And then you see video clips where they show looks like off-duty police officers or someone that's affiliated with the police department. I seen a video where, you know what I mean, someone had a dash cam in their car and the dash cam showed this dude that looked like he could be a police officer basically walk side by side by another car, got the shooting at the car, gets in the car he was walking besides, and they drive off. So don't get it twisted, man. Don't think that all these deaths and shootings that's happening in Chicago is by black-on-black crimes, man. And then on top of that, Ray Lewis will say that, but Ray Lewis ain't talking about all the white-on-white crime. There's more white-on-white crime than damn near any crime that's out here now. You understand what I'm saying? Come on, let's get this shit together, man. Stop trying. Like, he ain't even bring up the fact that, you know what I'm saying, that white people kill more police officers. Listen to me now. White people kill. White people shoot at more police officers than black people. He didn't mention that, though, right? Because he's on that coon train. If you don't know what the coon train is, I'm about to let you know. And this is how I'm about to end this show tonight. So, see if I can pull this up, man. Appreciate those that, you know what I mean? Shouts out to Africa Lattimore. Support that female. Support that sister right there. She's doing her thing. You know what I'm saying? She's a director straight out of Naptown, Indianapolis, Indiana. She's a director, a film director. You know what I mean? I had the opportunity to work in one of her projects, which is Loyalty 2. Okay. Let me see. I know the movie. I got the movie case over there. K Can you throw me that movie case? I'm gonna go ahead and plug you real nice. It should be like over in. It's not over here. Oh, well, the movie case. I ain't got the movie case right now. The movie case is in another room. But shouts out to Africa. You know what I'm saying? Go check out Loyalty 2. She also did Loyalty 1. I wasn't in that, but I was in the second one now. Now, I mean, many more projects coming from Africa, you know what I mean? So check that out. So before I get up out of here, man, I just want to be able to, you know what I mean, leave it like this. Shouts out to your boy. Shouts out to everybody that joined me for the night. Nah, this nigga Steve come in all late, son. Get better, man. You know what I'm saying? Get it together, my nigga. You know what I'm saying? Get it together, bruh. You know what I'm saying? Hope you make it through that, man. I know you will, man. You a strong brother. You know what I'm saying? Shouts out to everybody that checked me out tonight. I'm going to be on 5 p.m. Central, 6 p.m. Eastern. You understand what I'm saying? Right now, I'm going to continue going through Facebook Live. Man, let me lick my lips because, you know what I'm saying, they start looking like all chapped in ash. But I'm going to be here, you know what I'm saying, every Sunday, 5 p.m. Central, 6 p.m. Eastern. Go to ComedianJScott.com, you know, check out, you know, what I got going on. I got a couple things that's available as far as merchandise, t-shirts, a comedy mixtape. If you're in the San Antonio area, you know what I mean, I'll be at the Laugh Out Loud on Tuesday, emceeing the open mic showcase part. So, you know what I mean, that's going to be fun. So, you know what I mean, you know, I want to salute everybody that checked in with me tonight. And I appreciate those that, you know, that rocks with me. I'm not going to be cussing too much because I know Mama Kishmel's in the building, so I'm not going to be doing too much cussing, but trying to keep it PG-13 as much as I can. But you know what I mean, I've been on here for over an hour, so you know, the shows may end up being around that time, an hour and a half, something like that. But you know, I'm trying to get it in with the visual clips and all that, I'm trying to wake y'all niggas' minds up, you know, continue to wake my mind up. But I'm about to sign off. I'm about to be out, but I wanted to play this clip. This is for Ezekiel Elliott. This is for Ray Lewis. This is for, what's that sheriff? That sheriff in Milwaukee. What's that nigga name? I don't know. Look him up. The sheriff in Milwaukee. All right. This is for all these people right here, man. Once I get past this advertisement on my YouTube page. I'm out, y'all. Man, I ain't gonna lie, man, that's just hilarious, man. Shout out to Tariq Nasheed, man. You know what I mean? Holler at that brother, you know what I'm saying? It's shit funny, man. I'm out though. Once this is off, man, I'm out though, man. right, man. That's it, man. Comedian Jay Scott, I'm out. Appreciate everybody. Hit me up in the chat room. Holla at your boy, comedianjscott.com. Got any music, anything you want to send me, any videos, you know what I mean? Either share it on my YouTube page. Oh, shit. Share it on my YouTube page. Or, you know what I'm saying, hit me up at comedianjscott.jc@gmail.com. I'll play your music, you know, maybe even get an interview with you. You know what I mean? I'm working off a couple things, so maybe I can get a phone interview with you, something like that. But we're going to make this happen, man. I'm out, man. Peace.